You mentioned about trade, and everybody's watching about the trade war between US and China. But faced with the trade war, China, instead of closing down, is continuing opening up and even speed up some of its reforms and the market. You mentioned also in your speech RCEP as well as CPTPP as the trade pacts that China is currently actively pushing forward. So how do you see the prospects of these two trade pacts? Also because they're quite different, one is of much higher standard. Do you see the two of them are interlinked? Also, how would they integrate into, help China to integrate into the global trading system?
In my mind, I think the best choice is we have a full global multilateral rules on the trade and the investment. But in case that people don't agree with each other, there is a friction and tariff wars. So if we can have a smaller scope of global multilateral rules, I think it's also a good choice. Now, for today's world, the world population is something around 7.5 billion. That's if the global trade regime, the multilateral system, does not cover full 7.5 population. For example, just cover 5 billion or 6 billion population. It's a still a very large system. It's a still a very good choice. If we review to see that in 1985, around 1985, the total global population was probably only 5 billion. So what I say that if we use RCEP, CPTPP to set up a regional multilateral trade and investment rule, I think it's a great thing. And I hope it can expand to have more connection with Europe, with Latin America, with Africa, and then can bring up tremendously the economic and the trade efficiency and also the investment opportunity. Looking back to the period before 1990, from the end of World War II up to 1990, there were several systems. One is the GATT, covered that's most Western country and free market economy. Another is so-called CMEC, so the Conference of Mutual Assistance country, led by the former Soviet Union and the Eastern European country. China was not included at that time because at that time China was too poor. They say that's only unilateral assistance to China, but China at that time was not useful to assistance to the CMEA countries. There were the UN quotas to have developing countries. They have their own opinion and the claim for the international trade system. So it can be understood that people may have a different opinion and they try to have their what they claim to be a best system for themselves. And through the competition, gradually people can realize that which is a good system. But in case some country try to escape, then we have a phenomenon of somebody called globe minus one or globe minus few. But I think, we can also, through the RCEP, CPTPPs, to have a second best global multilateral system. And gradually, I believe, finally, that's a global is going to reach a consensus to have a high standard trade and investment system. Thank you.
Thanks. So have the second best first and hope to move that to the global system and revise it. In order for China to further in this global trade system, also often mentioned in the US-China trade talks as well, some of the policies in China are often mentioned and think needs to be addressed. I'll list a few here, including continue opening up its financial markets, liberalizing investment rules, reducing subsidies to state-owned enterprises, and better protection of intellectual properties. How would you address those issues?
If I may put in two angles. The number one is that domestically, China need those reform to deepening those of reform. We already have a consensus and already make a decision. For example, what you said that the financial sector opening up. But some of them are still in the process of debate and gradually may reach the higher level of consensus and the decision to deepening those of reform. China, after 40 years of economic reform and open door policies, basically people understand very well that we need the reform. We need to do those of things better. And we still in the halfway in the whole reform and transition period. In this sense, I mean, it's not because of pressure of outsiders. It's not because that we would like to join the international system, but we deeply realize that it's our internal need. The second angle is to say that China benefits a lot from WTO. Also from the early stage when China negotiated with GATT in Uruguay around this, we benefit from that. But in China, somebody also would like to create a very special Chinese ways of development to say that the Chinese development strategy with unique Chinese characteristic. But what I would like to say that many sports, like football, basketball, volleyball, tennis, badminton, when you try to participate in international competition, to participate in the championship, then you have to follow the rules. It's not very much important for you to argue whether the rule of basketball is optimal, is the best or not. Maybe it's for different country, the tower, but the people are different. So you may say that I would like to have the best rules of basketball like this, but it's actually meaningless. Whether you participate international event or not. So now it's also, I think, for China to think about that if we are already highly involved in global economy, we need to carefully study those of international rules and to think about what kind of reform we can do, we can accelerate to have a deeper participation of a global system.